During the Apollo missions, when humans last ventured to the moon, they faced significant technological limitations and a lack of established systems to aid their expeditions. Nowadays, NASA is preparing to commence the building process of a dedicated lunar space station named the Gateway, which will be designed to establish a significant connection between Earth and the lunar surface in orbit. This ambitious project aims to facilitate advanced deep space scientific exploration and research for future generations. The construction of the Gateway involves collaboration between NASA, the European Union, Japan, Canada, and various private aerospace companies. Similar to the International Space Station, the Gateway will function as a globally shared outpost. However, unlike the ISS, this station will be positioned much farther away from Earth, approximately 1,000 times the distance, and will serve as a launchpad for missions to the moon's surface. In this episode, let's take a look at the inside of the Gateway, talk about unique systems inside its small area, especially at the beginning, and how it will be constructed during this decade until fully operational. Don't hesitate to subscribe to the channel and let's get into the topic. This is Adventures in Space. The construction of the entire Gateway space station will span multiple years due to various factors such as cost, time constraints, and the station's location. Consequently, the interior of the station will undergo significant changes as additional modules are added and its space and capabilities expand. Sadly, the Gateway will not be operational during the initial human return to the moon and landing of Artemis 3. However, it is planned for the Gateway to be prepared by the crew of Artemis 4, and it is expected to become functional starting from Artemis 5 mission. Now, in its initial phase, the primary role of the Gateway will be to act as a waypoint for crewed missions heading towards the lunar surface. The crew will dock their Orion capsule to the Gateway and transition to the station to make preparations for the journey to the moon. Afterwards, two members of the crew will transfer to the human landing system to descend to the lunar surface, while the remaining two crew members stay aboard the station. Once the lunar excursion is complete, the landing party will return to the Gateway using the HLS, reuniting with the rest of their crew, and subsequently board the Orion spacecraft for the return trip back home. As the Gateway station continues to develop and progress, its function will shift towards serving as a long-term research outpost. Eventually, the Gateway will have its own permanent crew, enabling sustained operations. The initial phase of the Lunar Gateway is scheduled for launch aboard a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket, potentially as early as November 2024, although a more realistic timeframe would be sometime in 2025. This launch will transport the two primary modules of the station together under a single fairing. First one named Halo, the Habitation and Logistics Outpost, and the second is PPE, Power and Propulsion Module. However, due to the substantial payload and the weight limitations of the Falcon Heavy, the journey to the moon will be lengthy. Instead of taking a direct high-speed trajectory, the payload will follow a slow arc that will span approximately 9 to 10 months before reaching the intended lunar orbit. The primary module, Halo, is currently being manufactured by Northrop Grumman in the United States. This module will serve as a central component of the station and is essentially a modified version of Northrop Grumman's Cygnus spacecraft, which functions as a primary supply ship for the ISS. The Halo module will serve as a docking location for the Orion capsule and HLS vehicles, as well as the living and working quarters for the crew throughout their mission. According to Northrop Grumman, the Halo module will provide space for the crew to sleep, exercise, prepare food, and conduct scientific experiments. However, it should be noted that the Gateway modules, including the Halo, have relatively small dimensions, resulting in a less luxurious experience. The Halo module has a diameter of only 3 meters, making it around 30% narrower than the core modules of the ISS. Additionally, due to a combination of weight restrictions and design limitations, the Halo module will not feature any windows, which could be a disappointing factor for future crew members. Prior to its launch on the Falcon Heavy, the Halo module will be integrated with the power and propulsion element, which is another contribution to the Gateway project from the United States. The PPE module is being developed by the satellite company Maxar Technologies. Once deployed in lunar orbit, the PPE will unfold two large solar panel arrays, each roughly the size of a football field's end zone. These solar panels will harness solar energy to generate an impressive 60 kilowatts of electric power for the Gateway. Additionally, the module is equipped with electric ion thrusters that utilize energy from the sun to accelerate low-density xenon gas. This propulsion system enables the Gateway to maintain its orbital trajectory. On March 31st, the NASA Gateway Twitter account shared a photo of a central cylinder of the PPE module, emphasizing that the PPE will make the Gateway the most powerful solar electric spacecraft ever flown. Currently, this first crewed mission to utilize the Gateway station is tentatively scheduled for 2028. Artemis 4, the mission in question, will not only involve the crew using the station but will also transport the third module for the Gateway, known as the International Habitation Module, iHub, developed by the European Space Agency. During Artemis 4, the iHub module will accompany the Orion spacecraft using the new exploration upper stage of the SLS Block 1B configuration. Upon reaching the Gateway, the Orion will dock the iHub module to the Halo module, specifically on the opposite end from the power and propulsion element. With these three modules connected, the Gateway will achieve full functionality. The iHub module will contribute environmental control and life support systems to the Gateway. It will feature essential facilities such as a gallery, hygiene and waste management systems, refrigerators, workstations, and control consoles. However, similar to the other modules, the iHub module will not have windows. Artemis 5, scheduled for 2029, will bring the European system, ESPRIT, to the Gateway using the same SLS Block 1B exploration upper stage. ESPRIT will provide refueling infrastructure and telecommunications, and it will introduce a cupola-style observatory window to finally allow the crew to view the moon from orbit. I suppose this will become a true highlight in the Gateway development, as for us humans, emotions gained out of any kind of view is the most significant part of any given experience. Additionally, Artemis 5 will deliver Canada Arm 3, an external robotic system for the Gateway. In 2030, Artemis 6 will transport an airlock module to enable spacewalks around the moon. The specifics of the airlock module are yet to be determined, but here's where a dedicated robotic arm will come very handy for the station overall. NASA will support the Gateway with supply missions using an upgraded SpaceX Dragon XL, launched on Falcon Heavy rockets for resupply and waste removal. Another important fact to notice about the Gateway station is its orbit. The Gateway will utilize a unique orbital path around the Moon called the Near Rectilinear Halo Orbit, or NRHO. This oval-shaped orbit takes 1 week to complete and maintains stability with minimal energy usage. At its perigee, or the closest point, the Gateway will be around 930 miles above the Moon's north pole, while at its farthest point, or its apogee, it will be approximately 43,500 miles away. This balanced orbit strikes a middle ground, requires less energy than a lower, tightly circulating orbit while still allowing access to the Moon's surface. This type of near rectilinear halo orbit enables the human landing system to reach various areas for exploration, maintaining continuous communication with Earth. As you're watching this video, NASA is testing the NRHO through the Capstone satellite, validating its viability for Gateway operations. In NASA's recent 2024 budget request, specific details are provided up to Artemis 7 in 2031, with Gateway operations indicated for the future. While the exact future remains uncertain, one key long-term goal for the Gateway is to serve as a launchpad for an expanded presence on Mars. By utilizing the Gateway as a staging point between Earth and Mars, larger and more complex payloads can be sent to the Red Planet. Refueling in lunar orbit would greatly simplify the challenging direct Earth-to-Mars journey, offering opportunities to establish a foothold in the solar system. The Gateway station is expected to play a crucial role in space exploration, despite its modest appearance and comfort level. If you want to explore more about the Artemis program and how the moon base will be constructed, then you should watch this next video right in front of you. Please consider subscribing to the channel to stay updated on everything space industry related, as we do 4 essays every week in relevant topics. As always, this was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you at the next one.